I'm Seamus, and I'm going to have a look at Yahtzee Croshaw's Battle Royale TV, which is the second game in his 12 games in 12 months project. But before I get this murder train rolling, can I just point out how completely crazy this project is? I've been programming in the C family of languages since 1990. I worked for an early online game back in the aughts. I even shipped an indie game a few years ago. I've built some prototype engines, so I know how hard and how slow development can be. And he's going to do 12 games in 12 months. That's kind of like some guy deciding to build his own Death Star in his backyard on the weekends. A lot of game designers don't even come up with 12 entirely original ideas in their entire career. So this is very ambitious. But fine, I'll play it. All right, Yahtzee, you madman, let's see what you have for me. Okay, the premise of this game is that I'm running some sort of TV station where I watch people fight to the death. And here I can see the contestants that are about to compete. And already, look at this. For the record, he supposedly has a month to work on these, but this past month, I know he went to E3, and that's like a whole week of time, plus some recovery. I know how hard cons are on you. And even at that, he still has this full-featured. Like, I know entire indie games that do not have this much customization in their character creator. Like, look at this. In fact, I don't know if I've ever seen one with this much customization. I can't think of one that, like, an indie game. I mean, you know, AAA game that lets you... Saints Row could let you do more than this. But, like, an indie game that lets you customize this many different things on the... And this isn't even your character. This is just the contestants that are about to murder each other. There, and I can rename him. So, okay, we can go back, we can look at some of the other people. This is a lot. This, if I was making this game and all I wanted was to schedule the art alone for this character creator, I would ask for more than two and a half weeks, which is about what he had to do this entire thing after E3. So our objective for this first round is to just get 5,000 viewers. And let's start the game. You can see players parachuting into this battle royale, and then I have to place the camera on one of them. Okay, drone camera will capture anything interesting that happens around it. So now we're watching this person, Ophelia Zone Thrust, obviously a fan favorite, and we're just gonna watch her play. Oh, and she got a kill, that's really good. And now she's looting the building, so you can see how this goes. We sort of pick someone to watch, then the round ends. Now, that's not the entire Battle Royale round, but like, you get these 5-10 second increments. And I can choose someone else. The strategy seems to be look for somebody that's about to do something interesting. For instance, you know, someone that's about to murder someone else. I'm gonna stick with Ms. Zone Thrust here. Oh, that's interesting. I know from the dev diaries that Yahtzee programmed this so that players head for the middle of the zone, but if they're in the middle, then they'll kind of run around fighting each other. So these characters are well within the exclusion zone, so now they don't have anything to do but loot and murder. Kind of disappointed we'll try another round. And Zone Thrust seems to be letting us down here. Come on, go murder some people. Oh, missing out. This is where the action is, over here in the middle. Oh, come on. Shoot Mona Little Root. Nope. Oh, Zone Thrust died. So I think I've beat this already. I think I've gotten enough good footage to... Let's watch Jeremy Wafting. Yeah, we've got over 7,000 viewers now. So now we're just waiting for the round to play out. And got a kill, so now we're down to the last two players. That's pretty cool. We've more than beaten the level now, but, you know, we're still... I'm not sure what effect it has to just rack up more score, but there it is. That's the end of the round. Mona Little Root is the winner. All right, move on to the second season, which I guess is the second game. Okay, I need 12,500 viewers. And we have bonus objectives, like make sure certain people survive the first two rounds. And record. Corpses be... Okay, okay. So what I'm curious is, do people, like, survive? Do they respawn? This looks like all new people. So I'm going to say no. I think this is permadeath Running Man style, where everybody just dies. Now I can click on players to temporarily make the move in a specific direction. All right. I realize that it's a bit odd to... It's totally unreasonable to, like, criticize this game. This is amazing for the time available to work on it, but I feel like it goes against the sort of the spirit of me talking about this game if I don't offer some sort of analysis or criticism. So, I think what I would like to see is a little more for the player to do. I mean, I can order people to move around, but I think I'd like some sort of risk or reward system. I think it might be good if you could say, sometimes you're just stuck, you know, you're watching somebody and they're not going to be able to do anything interesting. They're just too far from everybody else, and you're stuck following this player, and you can't, during these rounds, you can't change who you're watching. You can't move your drone around. So I think I'd like maybe a feature where you could tell the drone to pull back. So it gets a bird's eye view of the battlefield, but, you know, all your footage will be less interesting because it's from further away. Or you can go high risk and try and, like, here I have these two people right in the middle that are very close to each other. I could tell the drone, oh, move in real close, and the amount of area that I could see would become very small, but the footage would become more valuable. That might be a good... something like that to give the player a little more of a decision beyond who to watch. I was supposed to make sure somebody survived, but I did not do that. And that's the round. Wolfgang Coatrut. This is completely unrealistic. I can't handle a battle royale game where nobody has weed names and everything's spelled correctly. It's breaking my immersion. No, seriously, that was really interesting. Quite a lot done for 2.5 weeks. At this point, you would normally expect, okay, go on and make this into a full game, because you've got a gameplay loop and a full set of mechanics to work with. But no, Yahtzee's going to move on to the next game. I'm looking forward to seeing it, although I still think he's crazy.